Hey guys! That's, this is Fastway. And I'm Rob from Boston. How's everyone doing? Come back to do a long time vinyl update. It's been a long time. Hope that ain't too loud. Just figured I'd start off the video with this album. Just wanted to touch base. I watched Nathan's amazing video today. He went on a little vacation and snuck down to see Raul. I just wanted to say how great it was seeing that. You know, the friendships in the vinyl community, seeing it, just wonderful, you know? I love seeing, you know, you guys getting together with friends and the vinyl community, meeting up and all that good stuff. And it made me feel so good. I wanted to touch on a few things as I go along today, but I'm going to be showing some new records, and also, my yelling, I apologize. I just had it right in front of me. I'm going to be playing, cuts from, what the heck did I do with it? I'll come across it eventually, I don't know where it is, but It's an album called Genre. Let's see if it's here again. Here it is. Chris gave this to me, Astral Traveler. So you'll be hearing a little of this today. An amazing, amazing jazz album. Independent label. Anders, everyone else that's into jazz in the vinyl community would appreciate this album. I'd love for everybody to look it up. It's called Commercial Success. So, Chris, hello. Anders, everyone else in the jazz, listens to jazz, the vinyl community. Let's start showing you some records. I like this song. This band I saw with Coney Hatch and Iron Maiden during the 1984 tour at the Cape Cod Coliseum. Bill Evans, I just bought a Bill Evans, George Russell Orchestra album too, but I'm going to play a little of that Genre album and give you a little taste of it. I hope you like it. Here it is. So, some of the albums I picked up. I picked up this album from a band called The Blessing. Every time I pick up, you know, any type of metal albums, 80s metal, this is Sealed. I don't know much about it. If anyone can help me out, I'd appreciate it. It's called The Blessing. And I also got Pink Fairies. This is an Italian copy of Kings of Oblivion. Again, really good album. From 73, I believe. Now, when I see stuff like this, I think of Greeno. You know, because he pretty much has everything when it comes to this type of music. 70s bands, you know, hard rock bands, metal bands. LJ's been showing some really good stuff too lately, but for some reason, I always think of Greeno because he's got everything under the sun. Hey, Greeno. LJ. I keep saying I apologize. I picked up Grant Parker. Otavio just showed this. If you want to get a good Grant Parker album, get this one. It's good. Discovering Japan, Local Girls. This came out in 79. It's a really good album. It reminds me of the 80s. But it's great. I always appreciated Grant Parker. Smoking Popes. You know, Jim Hankey showed this a while ago, and Mark Pudinski got a copy, too. Right around the same time I did, but they had a different cover on the CD. This was never released on vinyl. It's called Born to Quit. All I can say about the Popes is anyone who hasn't heard these guys or this album, please check it out. It's fantastic. It grows in you. It just gets better and better. Well-written songs, really good music. Check it out, alright? That's the new Smoking Popes, newly released on vinyl, first time ever. I also picked up, thanks to Bostonian Reggie getting me off my butt, I picked up The Modern Lovers. This Genre album is so good. I gotta lower it just a little. Really fantastic band, Unknowns. And after this album, they just disappeared into oblivion. So happy that Chris gave me this record. This is Modern Lovers, first album, I believe. I should know this being from Boston, but Mike, Bostoni, and Reggie finally got me off my butt to find a copy, and I did. So thanks, Mike. Great album, great band. Thanks to Fred for this one. Sozel, I never say this right. Sobel, Sobel, Sozbel, six-letter word, I can't pronounce it. One of those stories, you know? Guy puts out a record and disappears, and things are fantastic. So, thank you, Fred. Everybody, I think Final Community must have bought up 30 of these. But they had them on eBay for like $9. I've been telling Fred I was going to thank him for the longest time now, and I finally did. Yeah, J.D. McPherson, Signs and Signifiers. Ingrid just showed this recently. Hi, Ingrid, Netherlands. And Dave, someone for you. He wanted, got me to buy it. And am I glad that I did. One of my favorite records in the last probably 2 years. Rockabilly sounding. The guy's got a boatload of talent. Anybody wants to... Brandon, you would like this album. Same with you, Maggie. I was just telling Laura, too, about this record. One of the comments that I left her. But everybody should check it out. It's really, really good. I got Henry Cow's first album, debut. If it wasn't for the Vinyl Community, I probably never would have bought this record. But this is a German copy on that label. Say that label, it's pretty bad. I should know that label, and it's... I can't think of it. Whoever knows it, tell me what it is. I forget, it's on the tip of my tongue. Yeah, I picked up Weather Report at Goodwill. Everybody knows this album, great band. And the George, Bill Evans George, this is wild. I mean, this is like wild music. It almost sounds like jazz prog. Bill Evans is an artist that Anders has been helping me with. So thank you, Anders. I picked up the 20th anniversary of Beastie Boys, still sealed. Didn't open it yet. Bobby. Bebop and Bobby. Baby. Hi, Bobby. He likes to keep things sealed, and so do I, but I'll have to open this one up because I haven't heard it in about 25 years. I really appreciate the Beastie Boys. Beastie Boys music. Bonko. Now, commercial success is on right now. I'm going to put a little Bonko on, too, so you'll be able to hear it. Italian progressive music. Now, this is their fourth album. The name of the band is not Bonko, by the way. It's Bonko del Muto Soccorso. And Monsters. Monsters for Italian prog. For some reason, I just thought of Dave, Fatback Funk. I don't know why, but anyone who likes progressive, Italian progressive, Sarah just showed there's three really good progressive bands in Italy. PFM, Leorme, and these guys. I have a few Leorme albums, and also PFM. Is it PFM? PMF? God, PFM, I think. I shouldn't dig it out now. I'm wasting time. Yeah, PFM. But if you want to hear a great, great, great album, great band, check out this band here. This Bonko album's fantastic. Now, this song is Metamorphosize. It's Italian for metamorphosis. It's like an epic, long song. Gets heavy. Really good. Dynamite band from the 70s. Thanks to Andrew Turntablist for pushing me into getting this. Andrew showed it, and I bought it. It's on the Manicore label. It's an original. All right, continuing. I got this Rob Soul sealed. I don't know anything about it on this Parlophone label, but there's a lot of Beatles. Marv, Joe... Beatles collectors in the vinyl community. There's a few others who love the Beatles. So you might want to... might help me... find out where the heck it's from. Continuing real quickly. Sorry I'm taking so long. Oh yeah, I got the new Morrissey. Hey Jan. And Brett. Brett showed this. The new Kill Uncle reissue. Trying to think. Yeah, Jan 68 Baz Jazz showed the new single, Last of the Famous International Playboys. So this is the new Kill Uncle. He omitted a song off the original Kill Uncle, and he added Passionate Love and East West on it. River, I think. River and Shelley have the original Kill Uncle, and there's a few other people in the vinyl community that have it too, but I had to get it, you know? It's a reissue, I had to get it. It's nice, sounds good, and this is something I'll never play. It will just go in my collection. Sorry this is so sporadic. I got the new Jack White 7-inch for the etched disc there. What am I doing for time? Pretty good. It's like an etched disc. You probably can't... Yeah, you can see it a little bit. See there? Few more and I'm done. Painless. John McLaughlin. I think I showed this before, but Electric Guitar is the name of it. And it's great. I mean, the artists on this album. You got Chick Corea, Stanley Clark, some of the best bass players. Jack Bruce. You got Billy Cobham on drums. I know there's more. Fernando Sanders plays bass. David Sanborn plays sax. Tony Smith plays drums. I mean, this thing is loaded with... He knows every good musician around, doesn't he? Fantastic record. Ramones. I found an original copy of Brain Drain. That's just the Joey Ramone single I put in there because it kind of got the same colors and it looked cool. This is Brain Drain. One of the later albums from the Ramones. And I'm... And I also picked up Adios Amigos. So I'm literally, their last album as a band, the Ramones, I'm literally one album away from completing my Ramones collection finally, which reminds me to say about the Replacements. Yeah, Craig did a video recently, and Travis showed some Replacement albums, and Travis got some Replacement albums, and Craig wanted a you know, put a request out. If anyone finds any Replacement albums, if you could give him a call, it'd be great. Because he's looking for it. He doesn't have any in his collection and he wants to find some. Hi, guys. OMD. Finally picked up Crush. I think of Gil every time I see this band now. So that's, first side of this is great. I mean, every single song in the first side is fantastic. And I picked up the new Stone Temple Pilots, Purple, on purple vinyl, which was nice. I always wanted to get this on vinyl. I only have, Chords coming out too. I don't want to dig through it and find it, but I have other Stone Temple Pilots on vinyl, but Chords being reissued, as everyone probably knows. This is great, if anyone wants to hear a good album. And, finally, the George Russell, Living Time, whatever, blah, 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 Bill Evans. This is like heavy stuff. This album here. I am so glad that Anders hooked me onto Bill Evans because, what a talented guy. I'm really happy that I'm getting into jazz, period, but. And then finally, I found, one of my favorite newer glam rock bands, Foxy Shazam. And this is introducing Foxy Shazam. What's his name? Eric Sean Nally and crew. A lot of people say they sound like Queen. Which they kind of do, but it's neat. This was a pressing of 1 out of 700. Something like that. So that's it. You know, I hope you like my update. I don't think I forgot anything. Except to say how much I love the vinyl community, and I love you guys. I love everybody in the vinyl community, but thank you for watching. Hold on. Billy Creone wanted me to show this. This is the Milli Vanilli 6-track promo, Billy. I don't know if you're watching this. Yeah, so that's it. Love all you guys. I hope you hung in there for the whole video. Keep on enjoying your endless summer, and I'll catch up with you in your videos. Bye-bye. Love you guys.